the serpent is trying to raise up in arms.
Yes, he is.
And he's running rampant.
Yes, he is.
And God has given me a word, amen, concerning this issue. I do not take it lightly to stand before you this morning. I too was incarcerated for 17 years of my life.
Oh God.
If I could just give you just a bit of my testimony before.
Give it to us.
My life took a turn for the worse. At an early age, I became addicted to drugs.
Oh God.
Crack cocaine was my God for many, many years.
Amen.
The damage that I'd done, I thought it was irreversible. But little did I know that God had a plan and a purpose for my life.
Oh God.
My mother, she raised us right. I was in church as a young man, and I knew the way. But it was something about the world that I just had to taste it.
Come on now.
Oh, Jesus.
May I say to you this morning, the hold of sin is so strong.
That's right.
Sometime you might not make it back.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Say that.
But I thank God. The Almighty God will spare my life.
Yes.
Amen.
If you have your Bibles this morning, turn with me to Romans chapter 6. I'm going to be coming out of verse 23, and I'm just going to use one passage of scripture. Because I really believe that there is something that God wants you to hear this morning.
Oh, God.
When you have it, say amen.
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 For the word of God says, for the wages of sin is death.
Yes, it is.
Can I read that one more time?
One more.
For the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. Let us pray. Father God, I thank you right now. Lord, and that you're King of Kings.
Yes.
Lord, I thank you that you sit high, oh God.
Thank you, God.
And that you look low.
Yes, God.
Lord, I thank you this morning, oh God, for my being, oh God.
Bless you, God.
Lord, we thank you this morning, oh God, for your spirit, oh God. Lord, just allow your spirit to reign supreme, oh God, in this building this morning, oh God. Lord, let the hearts and let the ears and the minds, oh God, be receptive, oh God.
Yes, God.
To what it is that you have to say.
Yes.
Bless God.
Lord, this is so important, oh God. Lord, this is life or death, oh God. Lord, as we look towards you this morning, oh God, from where we've come for help, oh God.
Come on, God.
Lord, pour out your spirit, oh God.
Do it, Jesus.
Lord, that we won't leave out the same way we came in.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we're grateful, oh God, that you brought us over the highways and byways this morning, oh God.
Oh, yes, God.
With no hurt, harm, or danger. Lord, we're even thankful, oh God, Lord, that you woke us up this morning, oh God.
Yes.
Our uprising wasn't in vain.
Yes.
Lord, we're just so grateful.
Thank you,
Jesus. God and God alone.
Thank you, Jesus.
And Lord, we reverence you this morning.
My God, my God.
We give you glory. We give you honor.
Yes.
And we give you praise. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The book of Romans is the revelation of God's wrath against sin.
Come on, bro. Say that.
And the righteousness through faith as the grounds of justification.
Oh my.
Now, we as human beings that are created in the image of God, we have a personal instinct, if you will, when it comes to someone being wounded, someone being stabbed, or maybe someone having organ failure, or someone being in a very, very bad accident. And what we do in these situations is, when it's someone that's close to us, or when it's a relative, we stop what we're doing.
Come on.
Immediately.
Oh, God.
We stop what we're doing immediately.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Give it power.
These situations are considered to be emergencies.
Say that, bro.
And if I was to take for a title this morning, I would use simply, this is an emergency.
All right, all right, all right.
And if I was to use for a topic, my topic would simply be sin. As we encounter these situations, there are things that we have to do. Normally, when these things occur, someone has been rushed to the hospital.
Oh, God.
As we drop what we're doing, we rush and see about our loved ones, and we get there, we inquire about what's going on. We ask the doctors, what's going on? What can be done?
Bless God.
Emergencies, as defined, is a serious, unexpected, and often dangerous situation.
That's right.
Requiring immediate attention. Action.
Come on now.
Wow.
May I say to you this morning?
Say it, brother.
If you are in sin,
come on now.
Oh, God.
Say it.
You are in an emergency situation.
All right, all right.
That's right.
That situation that you are in, if you're in sin, you are requiring some immediate action.
Come on now. Help us, Jesus. Help us, Jesus.
Human and earthly sensual wisdom, is one of the things that it teaches us how to get into sin
But it doesn't teach us how to get out of it.
No, it don't.
That's right.
No, it don't. Jesus. Help us, Lord.
And as a result of this, you or we as a victim are helpless.
Mm.
Uh-huh.
And may I say to you this morning, if you are a victim or a sinner, then it's going to take the same power.
Come on now.
The same mighty power that raised Jesus from the dead.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
To change your heart.
Come on.
Touch us.
In a moment.
Yes.
My God.
Yes.
I can remember times when I was out. Mm-hmm. On these drugs. There were times where I just felt like I couldn't deal with it anymore. I felt like that I used to tell my mother, I need to go to prison. I need to be locked up somewhere to keep me from getting to this drug. Because I felt like it was no other way that I could deal with.
Help us, God. Help us, God.
And as time went on, how many of you know that there's power in the tongue?
Yes, it is. Come on, speak it.
Jesus.
As time went on, it got worse and worse.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to the point where I really actually tried to kill myself.
Oh, God.
I remember going to the railroad tracks. One night I had just been out for hours and hours at a time.
Bless him, Jesus. Bless him, Jesus.
And the enemy had been dealing with my mind so bad that it actually felt like somebody was just scraping the top of my head.
Jesus.
And just taking a hammer trying to dig in and get to my mind.
Come on now, Lord.
Jesus. Yes, sir. My God. Jesus. Have a son.
Even at that very moment, God let me know that the enemy was trying to attack my mind.
Mm-hmm. My God.
He was trying to take me out.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Because that's what he do. He comes to kill. He comes to steal and he comes to destroy.
That's right. My God. Yes, sir.
Well, if you're in that state this morning, I say to you this morning that Dr. Jesus,
come on now,
is waiting on you.
Come on now.
Dr. Jesus,
say it,
is waiting to do whatever surgery that you need done.
Come on now.
He's waiting to reach way down.
Way down.
And pick you up.
Yes.
Out of your seat.
Yes.
See, you can't go to Roland Memorial emergency room.
No, you can't.
Come on now.
And get this treatment.
That's right. That's right.
You can't go to Forsyth emergency room and get the treatment that you need.
Come on now.
The treatment that you need is
say that.
Sin,
say it.
You can only get it.
Come on.
From Jesus.
That's right. That's right. Come on.
Right. Say it.
He says in 1 Kings 8:33, and for the sake of time, I'm not going to read these scriptures.
Come on, bro.
He says in 1 Kings 8:33, he says, turn to God and be converted.
Come on now.
He says, confess the name of God.
Yes.
In verse 33 and 35.
Yes.
He says, make supplication to him.
Yes.
In Philippians 4 and 6.
All right.
He says, turn.
Come on.
From sin.
Do it. Do it.
He says, fear him.
Come on.
In verse 43.
All right.
He
all
says,
right.
Repent.
Come on.
Make supplication.
Yes.
Acknowledge sin.
Come on. Call it what it is. Call it what it is.
Jesus.
He says, return to him.
Yes.
With all your heart.
Come on.
In all your soul.
Yes.
The penalty for sin is eternal death.
Yes, it is.
No question.
No way around it. No way around it.
Because the word of God tells us so.
That's right.
Death, as defined in Scripture, means eternal separation or the cutting off from realizing God's purpose.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
From which you were created. John 3:16. For God so loved the world.
Yes, he does.
He gave his only begotten son.
Yes, he did.
Mm-hmm. Now, I can just picture my Savior.
Come on.
Taking a beating like he did. Being whooped all night long.
Mm-hmm.
Why not?
Yes, sir.
Then being made to bear that cross.
My God.
Jesus.
All the way up on that hill.
My God.
Savior.
And then even then when he got there, they nailed his hands.
Yes, they did.
And they nailed his feet. And they hung him up. Even as everything had happened, the last thing that he said was, it is finished.
Yes, it is.
That sin debt that you and I carry was paid in full.
Yes.
That's right.
He finished it.
Yes. Paid in full.
So why do we continue? Why? He asked the question. He said, what shall we say now? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound?
God forbid.
He said, God forbid.
Help us, God.
The debt has been paid.
Yes.
It's been paid.
Yes, sir. My Savior.
2 Corinthians 5 and 17. We should walk in the newness of life.
Yes.
I'm sorry, y'all. I just get emotional. When God gave me this word, it just...
Bless him, God.
He just poured so much into me and made me realize.
Yeah. Oh, touch God.
He made me realize that every day that he allows me to wake up.
Come on now.
Amen.
I should live right.
Come on now. Amen. Say it.
Because I believe if you believe right,
yes,
then you will live right.
Tell him, bro. Come
Jesus
on now.
Cross,
all right.
Then you will live right.
Come on now. Say that.
My God.
Good word.
Jesus.
Therefore, we're buried with him
by baptism into death.
Say it.
That like as Christ was raised up from the dead.
Come on now.
By the glory of the Father.
Yes.
So we also should walk.
Amen. Walk in it. Walk in it.
Newness of
life. Walk in it. Walk in it. Walk in it.
That's right.
Come on.
Knowing this, that our old man,
oh, man.
Is crucified.
Yes.
With him. That the body of sin might be destroyed.
Mm. Come on now. Come on now. That's right.
That henceforth we should serve sin no more.
No more. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory to your name, Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah, God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord.
This is an emergency.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
So many friends of mine that I have known over the years. Friends that I used to get high with.
Jesus.
I remember I used to run up and down the road back and forth to New York. Getting drugs. A lot of those friends are dead and gone.
Don't you say, don't you say.
This is an emergency.
Yes, it is.
You can't afford to die in your sin. There is an eternal separation. Come on, somebody.
Come on now.
There is an eternal separation.
Yes, 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 yes.
Jesus.
There's a disconnection from the Father.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
The same God that created you and I in His image.
Yes.
Now, I don't know about you, but I don't want to be disconnected.
No.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
So many times we overlook the life of somebody that's in sin. I remember Jesus giving Paul a revelation. Paul was in prison. And they thought his ministry was over. They had wrote him letters. And Paul had wrote back and he said, well, I'm still getting the opportunity to minister to this one person. He's a preacher's son. And God said, that one soul is more important.
Come on and say that.
He gave Jonah the same illustration.
Yes, he did.
That one soul. See, if we would, we as believers, if we start treating this as an emergency,
Jesus,
I believe we can reach somebody.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
I know we got things we got to do. I know a lot of us are married. I know we got yard work we got to do. I know we got to cut the grass. And we got to go to work.
Not God.
But I'm talking about the one who created you to be able to do those things that you're doing.
Come on now.
Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body, that ye shall obey it in the lust thereof. Neither yield your members as
righteousness unto sin.
Mm-hmm.
But yield yourself unto God.
Come on.
I think I'm going to say that again. But yield yourself unto God.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
As those that are alive from the dead.
Yes.
Amen. You got to wake up.
Come on, say that.
And that scripture goes on saying, your members as instruments of righteousness unto God.
Yes.
For sin shall not have dominion.
Come on.
Over you.
That's right.
For ye are not under the law.
Come on and say it.
But ye are under grace.
Yes. Thank you, God. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Being incarcerated for that amount of time, I learned something. Even as the system broke me, as it broke me to the point to where I can obey rules and regulations now.
Mm-hmm.
I know my rights and my wrongs. I know what I should do and what I shouldn't do.
Come on, bro. Come on, come on.
But the most important thing of it was that I learned to depend on God.
All right.
Even in a situation to where I'm at my lowest.
Come on now.
Even to the point where I'm in a state of sin.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God.
I know that I got to call on Jesus.
All right.
My God.
Because see, he's the only one that can save me out of my sin.
That's right.
Oh, bless God.
And as time went on, mm-hmm. God began to deal with my heart. Because see, when I went in, I wasn't saved. Mm-hmm. God began to deal with my heart.
Jesus.
And I remember Elder Jones was having a Bible study. And I remember how when I used to come in off the weight pile, and they would be over there at that table, and I can feel the pull. I can feel it. I every time I walk past the table, I can feel that pull just pulling me over to that table.
Uh-huh.
But yet then I would resist it.
Yes.
Because sin was so great in my life. I was yielding all my members to him.
Yes, come on now.
Jesus.
Come on now.
My God.
Yes. That sin would keep me walking past that table. Mm-hmm. But how many of you know there has to be a turning point?
Come on.
It has to be.
One day. Enough was enough.
Come on now.
Jesus.
One day enough was enough.
Yes.
One day I got down on my knees. I said, Lord, for you I live.
Come on now.
And for you I die.
All right.
And as time went on, I began to yield all my members. The members that I used to yield to the devil,
yes.
I began to yield to God.
Say that, son.
And then it began to get easier and easier.
Come on.
Easier.
All right.
To do what was right.
All right.
It began to get easier to tell somebody else about Jesus.
Come on now.
Say something. Thank you. My God.
This life that I live.
Yes.
I know it's not mine.
Yes. Come on now.
Yes. I know that God has purpose for my life.
Yes. Bless Almighty God. Bless Almighty God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Glory to your name, God. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Satan has a trap and a snare set for you.
Mm-hmm.
You better do everything in your power
mm-hmm.
to find out who this Joe is
yeah.
and what he's trying to do to you,
Jesus.
That's right.
Because if you don't, the plan that he has for your life, he's going to carry it out.
That's right.
And you will not make it.
Thank you, God.
Sometimes I just don't understand, Elder, how those around us, even when we used to do things, do this sin together, they see the change. They see the change that God has brought in your life. They see it, bro. They see the change. They see that your steps are ordered by the Lord.
Yes, they are.
But yet still,
uh-huh.
My God.
They continue in sin.
Come on now.
You know the one thing that I realized when I was living in sin, I watched my mother for years. My mother hasn't been married, hasn't been with a man for maybe over 30 years. Maybe right at 30 years. But as we were raised up, we weren't fortunate enough to have a lot of things. But once she gave her life to Christ, and once she started dragging me to church, and once I was in the presence of God, even though I didn't know no better, I didn't know what was going on, the rest that I got in that assembly was so profound
mm-hmm.
that I still remember it to the day. And as time went on, I could see God making changes in her life. I could see a lot of times where we didn't have, God would provide.
Yes.
I could see a lot of times where we couldn't get from point A to B, God will make a way.
Uh-huh.